नमस्ते, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर के चौधरी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मैथडोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन यूनिवर्सिटी। माई सब्जेक्ट एनिमल फिजियोलॉजी एंड एंडोक्राइनोलॉजी। एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट कंडक्शन ऑफ नर्व इम्पल्स। प्रोशर डिफाइंड द नर्व इम्पल्स as the sum of mechanical, chemical and electrical disturbance created by a stimulus in a neuron. ठीक है। The most accepted mechanism of nerve impulse conduction is ionic theory proposed by Hodgkin and Huxley. This theory state that nerve impulse is an electrochemical event governed by differential permeability of neurilemma to sodium ions and potassium ions, which in turn is regulated by electric field. Then how the nerve impulse is generated? When a nerve fiber is stimulated by a mechanical, chemical, thermal or electrical stimulus of adequate strength, equal or higher value than the threshold value, you can see into the figure, the stimulated area of the nerve fibers comes in local excitatory state at the point of stimulation. In this area, the transmembrane potential increases and membrane becomes several times more permeable to sodium ions than to potassium ions. Sodium ions rapidly diffuse from outside to intracellular fluid due to electrochemical gradient, so that inside become positively charged with respect to outside, which further increases the permeability of membrane to sodium ions. This reversal of polarity across two sides of membrane is called depolarization, and the membrane with polarity is called depolarized nerve fiber. It is electropositive inside while electronegative outside. It lasts for less than 1/1000 of a second, so a nerve fiber can conduct about 1000 impulses per second. 1 second ke andar 1000 impulse generate kar sakte hain nerve fibers. Due to rapid inflow of sodium ions, the potential increases first to zero, then rise to plus 45 to plus 50 millivolt, and this newly developed potential difference is called the action potential. This action potential travel as a wave of depolarization along the length of the nerve fiber in a particular direction and is called a nerve impulse. इसको हम nerve impulse बोलेंगे. After the peak of action potential called spike potential, the permeability of the membrane to sodium ion decreases while it become more permeable to potassium ions, which rapidly diffuses out from the cytoplasm to extracellular fluid due to electrochemical gradient. Soon, this part of membrane regain its polarity and become electropositive on outside and electronegative on inside. This is called repolarization, and the nerve fiber is called repolarized nerve fibers. कि भाई जब एक्शन पोटेंशियल आया, जब स्टिमुलस आया, तो मेम्ब्रेन की परमेबिलिटी चेंज हो गई. बाहर की तरफ पॉजिटिव, अंदर की तरफ नेगेटिव होती है मेम्ब्रेन. लेकिन जैसे ही स्टिमुलस आएगा तो परमेबिलिटी बाहर की तरफ नेगेटिव, अंदर की तरफ पॉजिटिव, तो इसको हम कहेंगे पोलराइज्ड. लेकिन एज द स्टिमुलस क्रॉस, देन द पोलरिटी अगेन चेंज्ड, अगेन बिकम पॉजिटिव एंड इनर बिकम नेगेटिव. And you can say this is the repolarized membrane. A repolarized nerve fiber has some polarity at that as that of a polarized narrow fiber but has different ionic distribution. It has more potassium ion outside and sodium ions inside. The repolarized narrow fibers undergo a refractory period of a few milliseconds during which the original ionic distribution is restored by sodium-potassium exchange pump, which actively transport sodium ions out and potassium ions in. This returns the membrane to its resting potential, that is from plus 50 millivolt to minus 90 millivolt, and the neuron is ready to receive another stimulus. And the refractory period after an excitation, nerve fiber undergo a recovery period in which it regain its original ionic distribution and polarity and prepare itself for the next stimulation. This period of recovery of nerve fiber is called refractory period. कि जो आयनिक कंसंट्रेशन जो चेंज हो गई थी उसको वापस उसी में आना, अपनी पोलरिटी चेंज करना, उसमें जितना टाइम लगेगा उसको आप रिफ्रैक्टरी पीरियड कहो. द पार्ट ऑफ रिफ्रैक्टरी पीरियड इन विच द नर्व फाइबर इज नॉट एबल टू गिव रेस्पॉन्स टू ए स्टिमुलस ऑफ एनी स्ट्रेंथ इज कॉल्ड एब्सोल्यूट रिफ्रैक्टरी पीरियड. कि पार्ट ऑफ रिफ्रैक्टरी पीरियड, रिफ्रैक्टरी पीरियड का वो पार्ट जिसके अंदर नर्व फाइबर कितनी भी स्ट्रेंथ का आप स्टिमुलस दे दो रिएक्ट नहीं करेगा, रेस्पॉन्स नहीं करेगा, दैट इज कॉल्ड द एब्सोल्यूट रिफ्रैक्टरी पीरियड. इट इज़ अबाउट 4 मिलीसेकंड फॉर ए स्मॉल फाइबर, सो कैन कंडक्ट 250 इंपल्स पर सेकंड. इन फ्रॉग द एब्सोल्यूट रिफ्रैक्टरी पीरियड इज ऑफ 2 to 3 मिलीसेकंड. Absolute refractory period is followed by relative refractory period, during which the narrow fiber can be excited only by a stimulus of strength higher than the previous value. It is about 10 to 30 millisecond in frog and 3 millisecond in the mammals. Then one term is more, that is the summation. When a stimulus of less than the threshold stimulus, जो threshold value जितनी है उससे कम का stimulus आप apply करते हो एक narrow fiber को, it fails to evoke a response. However, if the same stimulus is repeatedly applied for a sufficient number within recovery period of time, the stimulation occur by summation, provided their sum is equal or greater than the required value. This is all about the conduction of a narrow impulse, how a narrow impulse is generated. This session is powered by digital version 2, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Woman University. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in the comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you. Thank you very much.